Hi everyone, welcome to Legend of Grimrock. This is a game I'm very, very excited to be doing for you guys. It's not something I'm particularly good at. It's not my genre that I play a lot, but I really have a lot of fun with it. It's great, great, great amounts of fun for me. It's basically a dungeon crawler-esque kind of, I guess RPG is the way I'd describe it. As I said, it's not something I normally would play, but I have been playing Legend of Grimrock 1 on stream, and I've been enjoying that a whole lot. And then Legend of Grimrock 2 came out, and I have to say the devs are very, very nice, and they sent me a key for this game. So I really, really wanted to do it as soon as I could, and here we are. So let's get started on a new game here. So I'll explain a couple of things here. So there's normal difficulty, hard difficulty, easy difficulty. We're gonna do a normal just because, as I said, I'm not the best at this kind of a game. And then you can opt to either create your own characters or just play with some. They're either predetermined or randomized. I'm not sure, but we always make our own characters. Come on, guys. And they also have an old school mode, which, as I said, it's a dungeon crawler game, and this turns off the auto mapping feature. So the game would normally map out areas for you so you can go back to them, but if you're really into some old school style dungeon crawlers, which, as I said, I've never really played much of the dungeon crawler genre, you could do this. And you have to put it down on paper, so you have to remember where you've been. Some of the puzzles are crazy. Absolutely nuts. So obviously I'm not hardcore enough for that. And there's Iron Man mode, which the game can only be saved at healing crystals, which makes the game a lot more difficult. It's like it's kind of like, I guess, XCOM's Iron Man mode, where you only have like one real save. And then there's a single use crystals where you cannot use the healing crystals more than once, which makes it really, really hard. If I know anything from Legend of Grimrock 1, it's that I don't want to turn any of that on. So let's get started with the character creation. So the way this game works is you have a group of prisoners chained together, and there's frontliners and there's people on the back. So the frontliners usually absorb all the damage, usually. There's certain cases where they will not. Mainly people attack from the side or spells and splash damage and things like that. Generally speaking, though, we want our melee and heavy hitters to be at the front and people with the most defenses to be at the front. So we're gonna, well, before we start with that, we're gonna take a look at all the races here. So you have humans, which are they gain experience faster. Insectoids are, I don't know. I'm trying to give you a rough estimate on one of these. They're good at willpower. They're not very dexterous or like vitality. So I would say that they make good spellcasters, more or less. Lizardmen are very high dexterity. A race, so they're very good at being like stealth and crits and light weapons and things like that. Minotaurs are essentially the big tanks, bulky, don't hit very much, and they, you know, they're basically just, I don't know, that's a good frontliner basically for you. And then you have a rattling, which is one of the new races actually in this game. They don't have a lot of strength, but they have higher dexterity. But they have more evasion and some more carrying capacity. And then there also can't be disease, so that's kind of interesting. I don't know anything really about this race, but I'll be sure to use them in this playthrough here. And they apparently are hoarders, so I guess with the frontliner, we're going to go with the Minotaur. And here you have a bunch of classes, and the classes are not restricted by race, so I can have a wizard Minotaur for all I care. Which doesn't really make much sense because the Minotaur has higher strength and stuff. So you want to kind of, I guess, pick something that kind of suits whatever race you choose. Or you can be crazy and just have like a whole bunch of Minotaurs that like are mages or something. You can do anything. But regardless, the disadvantage of being a Minotaur, of having a Minotaur, is they'll eat more because they're large and in charge. We can have an alchemist, which we can brew potions and defend yourself in combat by wielding firearms. So that's kind of interesting. There's barbarians who do not care about finesse in combat. So this is a very good class for the barbarian because it has a lot of health and he gets a lot of strength as well for more damage. So it's basically just more power. So I'm gonna make this guy barbarian. I'm gonna show you the rest of these. There's a battle mage, which the weight of equipped armor is reduced by 50%. They can actually cast spells with their bare hands, which basically is the beginning. They can cast as many spells as they want. And they gain some protection. The farmer is actually a funny class. I've talked to Pat about this. Apparently this is supposed to be the magic carp of the game, which is, it looks so shitty, but it becomes really, really good later. But basically, the farmer does not know how to wield a sword. You are familiar with digging ditches and irrigation for growth cycles of pit root plants. Basically, everything a successful adventurer would never need. So it is literally a useless class. Like here, I'll even show you. It gets no skill points. You cannot do a thing with the farmer. But however, whenever you eat, instead of slaying monsters, you gain experience by eating food. So if you use them as like a food sink, apparently they get a lot of experience. And they can be really, really good, I think. But we will not be running a farmer on this run. We have a fighter, which is a master of close combat. Use a lot of weapons and special attacks, take half the time to build up. I don't know much about the special attacks. This is a blind run, by the way. The knight is good at, I guess, equipping evasion and armor, basically defensive class, instead of just like high damage. Then you have your rogue, which is your backstabbing little jerk. Apparently really good at dual wielding, which is a new mechanic of this game, so you get a not as much of a penalty to dual wielding. I'll have a look at that. We're gonna run a rogue here, trust me. 1% chance per level to score critical hit with missile or throwing weapons. That's interesting, huh? Because I was actually thinking of making a crit heavy throwing or missile person, but I guess we'll, I don't know, maybe. Nah, I won't be doing that. Then we have a wizard, which is a wizard is just basically your low health, high willpower spellcaster. So as I said, we're doing a barbarian for this minotaur, and we're gonna call it Jack Witchell, because that is the most brutish individual I know. We're gonna put heavy weapons on him. And so we have a lot of skills here. I should actually go through these. We have alchemy, which is for crafting healing and energy potions. And apparently at the fifth level, we can when we craft bombs, we get 3 bombs instead of 1. That's interesting. We have athletics, which is you increase your health by 20 for each skill point. So that's a good, I guess, it would be kind of good for the minotaur, I suppose. Concentration increases energy and more energy regeneration. Light weapons is just for daggers and weapons like that. Heavy weapons is what the minotaur is going to use here. So basically like axes, two-handed swords, shit like that, I guess. Missile weapons for bows. Throwing, which is you can throw daggers or rocks or bombs or things like that. Firearms! This is something that's new here, and I'm actually really excited to see what this is. So it decreases... It's just basically a, I have no idea what it is, but it's just firearms. It just sounds amazing. And then you have accuracy, increases your accuracy by 10 for each, so we can do, oh, and you can do melee and attacks from the back row if you have a second point into accuracy, which is interesting. That's the notable thing about that. Because normally you can't, because there's 2 in the front, 2 in the back, as I said. Then we have a critical, which is, more critical hits with, throwing or firearms and things like that. So that's kind of interesting. I wanted to make a crit person. I think I will here. Then we have armor, which is, you just become better at equipping armor and then you don't gain any penalties either. So definitely for this person, this is gonna be one of my frontliners. So this person really needs some armor. Dodge is more of the evasion dexterity based stats. So this is obviously a big bulky minotaur, so we won't bother with that. And then we have various schools of magic, which I'm not too sure of what they do. From what I know from the first game, it's just, I don't know, it's just different flavors. Some monsters are resistant to certain things like that. So then we have that. As I said, it's your typical old school RPG kind of setup here. We have some resistances, which this person will not have any. We have 10 attribute points to spend. And so, for this character, he has low accuracy because of his dexterity, kind of negative because he's playing as a minotaur. So crits are not going to be his thing. Carrying is going to be kind of his thing. But mostly we want damage and dexterity with him. So we're going to max out his strength here, give him a couple more points of dexterity, and maybe just like, Yeah, that's good enough. We're not going to bother with willpower, like, at all. So I can't even take points out of this. I kind of want him, though, to be a little bit better at vitality. We'll do it like that. I don't know. Maybe like this? Yeah, here we go. Some more vitality. So that's what we're going to do. So strength is more damage with melee weapons and carrying capacity. Dexterity is accuracy and damage with missile weapons. Vitality is just speed, healing, and things like that. And willpower is just energy on... Apparently, in this game, it's not so much for... it used to be like a stamina meter, but now it's kind of not. It's more stamina for special attacks and mostly spellcasters. It's a bit complicated. I know. This is why you don't have to really go through this whole character character creation screen here. Then we got two traits. And so there's a whole bunch here. Aggressive, aura. So you get more energy. We get more resist cold. Carrying capacity is increased by 25 and food consumption rate is decreased by 25%. You could take this if you want your Minotaur to basically just be a pack mule and kind of be the same, I guess, as everybody else in terms of food consumption. Evasion. Fast metabolism, which is a lizard man ability, which is really good, actually. Oh, it looks really good. It makes him eat more, but who cares? Then we get some exceptionally healthy. One of your... There's a mutation thing for the rattling, which basically gets a random attribute, which is really fun. Immunity to poison if you're a lizard man. So some of these are race locked, so you have to, you know, kind of think about it. Cooldowns for all actions you performed is decreased by 10%, which could be nice. We gain one more skill level as a human. Tough, which is physical punishment resistance. Dexterity. You can get more dexterity. This goes over the cap, by the way. You notice that there's a cap. And so you could go over it with these kinds of things. Chitin armor, which is a thick shell. You gain 10 protection. Resist fire. Resist all 25% for the lizard bat. That's kind of nice. Humans can be a fast learner, which means they get in a lot more. One of the things we're going to do for the Minotaur is Headhunter, which is plus one strength for each skull carried. So whenever we find skulls, we just give it to this guy, and he'll just gain strength for that. We can get muscular body. Natural skin, which is just adds more protection. There's some resist poison, 25. Rage, which is... Oh, this is a Minotaur thing. Your strength is temporarily increased by 10 when you have less than 20% health remaining. You'd be playing on the edge with this, so I don't think so. And Strong Mind, which is more willpower. And Weapon Specialization, which melee attacks gain 7 accuracy. We're going to take that one, just to kind of bring his accuracy back onto par with everybody else, because he does not have a lot of accuracy. So that does it for the Minotaur. We're going to make another one here. And this one will be... let's see, we're gonna have a lizard band here. Oh man, he looks ugly. Let's give him a hood. All right, and I guess this will be, I don't know, canned. But no, let's make this Pat. So this is gonna be Pat, and he's going to be our light weapons and crit man. And he's gonna be a rogue. So rogue gain 1% chance to score a critical hit. So he's just gonna be critting out the fucking ass with like light weapons. Which means we're gonna max out his dex to basically give him as much basically evasion and damage. Now I'm not sure if this means apparently so I you would think that with melee weapons it would be a strength attribute, but apparently with light weapons it says light weapons no, it just does a higher accuracy. I think that it's kind of tied to that. We're gonna do a little bit of strength but and a little bit of vitality, but mainly it's dexterity for the evasion and the chance of scoring a critical hit. Well, apparently some weapons are dexterity based, so I guess we'll see. But he's going to be just very accurate and very kind of stealth-like, I suppose. And so we're giving him fast metabolism, so his energy and health regenerates really fast. And also, healing potions will be twice as effective at the downside of... He needs more food, but that's okay. I think that won't be a problem. Since he's one of the frontliners, he kind of needs this kind of stuff. And I think with this guy, I kind of want him to have resist all 25. Wow, he gets a lot of resistances if I do that. That is kind of nice, I won't lie. But I could also at the same time give him something like more dexterity. because that will increase his accuracy even further. And also, like, it's a bonus. He gets bonuses every level. So I think honestly, maybe agile would be best. I'm thinking about it. Yeah, let's make him agile, just because. I think he'll be tanky enough. He doesn't have nearly as much health, but he has a lot more resistances as well. So this person will be, I guess, myself, or, yeah, let's make it myself. This person will be a human wizard. And so the humans gain experience points 10% faster, so he's going to be also fast learner. So he's going to just be leveling experience, like, out the ass. That's going to be his whole thing. So we're going to be also giving him a lot of willpower so he can cast a lot of spells. I will also give him concentration for more energy regeneration while resting, and also increases his energy by 20 for each skill point. So that's going to be kind of nice, just to give him a lot of energy. And we'll give him fire magic. He's going to go into, like, basically, I think, dip into all the schools of magic, because he's, as I said, he's going to be a fast learner, so it'll be kind of nice. And also to basically give him a strong mind. So this should give him a lot more energy by the end game. That's my thoughts here, at least. Because that will just give him, like... I'm investing early into willpower, so that you'll get it later. A lot of ability to cast things later. And there's also vitality. So strength, he doesn't melee. Dexterity... Accuracy doesn't matter for spells. Evasion would matter, but he's in the back line, so he's just going to be like vitality and willpower, basically, just in the back there, doing all that kind of magic stuff. And our last person will be a rat. He will be a rattling, and he's also going to be an alchemist. So alchemists have a bonus with firearms, and they can brew potions and defend yourself in combat, like by firearms, basically. So this is just a guy that's going to be just doing a lot of alchemy, basically. That's my plan for him. What I'm going to have him do, actually, is throwing and firearms. So he's going to throw rocks and swords and shit like that. And then he's going to use the firearms, which is like a later on thing. So no missile weapons, unfortunately, for this point in the game. But I think firearms and throwing will be enough. You think with the firearms I'd name them after myself, but I'll make it canned. So for him, I think I want him to do some evasion. I don't know. I really don't know what to give him, because I'm giving him a really weird role. But for him, I'm also going to make him give him a random attribute when he gains a new level. So that's going to be kind of fun. Like, it's just one new skill point every time. And then his second thing will be, I don't know, actually. I can give him more. I don't think the damage bonuses apply. They don't really explain that, but I think I'd rather give him something safe. I don't know what to give him for that second step. He doesn't really have anything. You can make him muscular. A muscular rat. Maybe I should just try and do damage. I think the dexterity does, like, it says damage you deal with many. Yeah, I think we'll just keep going up. We'll just do a bit of vitality and strength. I don't think is going to really mean much for me here. I mean, what I could do is I could give him, like, the ability to be like a pack mule here. Because he'll eat less food as well, which is kind of nice. I mean, that's, you know, I don't know about carrying capacity. That's the whole thing. I just don't know what to do with this guy. I'm gonna regret it, I think. I'm gonna give him endurance, just because, well it's more food for the two other people here. And I think that's basically it. Now, you think, though, that... I should give myself a capital letter here. My clap. Okay. Well, there's also another little feature of the game. Basically, these portraits, you know, they're kind of neat. Like, you can make, like, a little mouse person here. They have custom portraits, and Jack really hates when I use this picture of him, but fuck it, it's hilarious. So we're gonna just put that's Pat. So I just made a bunch of custom portraits for this game. I don't care. This is kind of just fun for me. And there you go. He's gonna be really pissed when he sees this video and he sees that's his picture, but that's, you know what, that's all part of the fun. is making Jack Witchell mad. Oh no, I haven't used some skill points. Where? Oh no, I have one over here. I'll give him another dexterity point. All right, let's get started then. Oh, well, welcome to Legend of Grimrock, guys. And so we have our first little puzzle here. So the game essentially just works on like a grid system, and we can pick up items and we can explore around and all that kind of stuff. So here's our little stick here. We'll give it to Pat and we can toss that open. Here we are with the shipwreck. So you can see I'm kind of moving in like a grid fashion, as I mentioned. We can kind of go see what's over here. We have a rock here, so that's something for Ken to chuck at people. And we basically just explore by picking up stuff, and we kind of look at walls to see if there's any kind of like secrets or anything like that. That's essentially what the game is all about. It's all about the secret finding, the hunting, and all that kind of stuff. So, well, let's get going then. So we have a horned fruit already, and we can also open up his inventory here. So this is basically something that I guess he can eat. He's like a... wow. He's a naked... We're all naked right now, I should mention. So the stick that Pat has right now is a light weapon. It's just a branch, so it doesn't do that much damage. But, hey, for the time being, who cares? Oh, let's see what's over here, actually. Nothing. It's just like a shelter. See, I'm trying to be on the lookout for secrets because I'm very, very not good at that, and the fact that this is a blind run makes this even worse for me. And we got some pants to put on to. So Jack is the only one in our party that's gonna be wearing pants. We're gonna keep it that way. Now let's go into the water here. Neat. This is a very, very good looking game. And we have a bone club heavy weapon, which is something that definitely, since it's a heavy weapon, we'll give it to Jack. Oh, I should also mention, since I'm a spellcaster, I did go into, like, fire, so one of these is gonna cast something, if I recall. Oh, there we go. Okay, that's my first spell. So I now know how to cast magic. So I just right-click on these abilities, and here's a turtle. Eat a rock. Oh god. He ran at me. Do you see how fast that turtle was going? So this is essentially the combat in the game that you're going to get used to. This is you kind of just dance around, abusing this, system of the grid system, because they can't attack you diagonally, as far as I can tell. Oh, look, we have some turtle steak here. Mmm, delicious. So, well, Jack Witchell got wounded a little bit, but that's okay. So ideally, I want to have everybody participate in the combat, because I think that matters. But everybody gained a bit of experience, and me even more, because I'm a fast learner. So we gotta prepare. We can prepare magic just by now. There's a whole bunch of symbols here, as you can tell, but the magic in this game works like you learn the spells as you go by basically finding them on the ground. But you can also do just trial and error, you know, so it works either way. So we have a button here, which we press to go into here and fight another turtle. Unfortunately, Pat took some damage there, but that's okay. Uh-oh. Let me just pick up the turtle steaks, it's okay. And we're gonna just wait for him to go over here. As you can see, this asshole is kind of just waiting for me. The game was nice enough, actually, to give us all a bunch of weapons, and you can see I automatically pick up that rock again when I go on the ground. Oh, what the hell is this? I think I gave Can some of this food here. I'm just gonna make Pat hoard all the food. Turtle egg. Ooh, nice. This is probably why they're attacking us. We're kind of eating their children. Oh, wait, we have our first alchemy ingredient. Ether weed. Okay. And, oh, look! Treasure! Oh, we got fucking boots and, we also have a torch here. The torch will come in handy. It does, fire damage. And we also have a smoked sea bass. I don't know why someone would carry that in their treasure chest, but I'm giving most of the protection stuff to Jack, and then Pat gets it next. So this is the kind of secrets that you get accustomed to in this game. And I'm also kind of looking on the ground for stuff here in the water. Oh, there's a little beetle there. Oh, there's bones here. Oh, there's a dart. Oh, it's a throwing weapon. Okay, well, we'll put that in Can's other hand. So now he has a... Oh, there's another dart there, actually. Now, if I miss stuff, just don't get mad. It is me. I'm not, as I said, the most perceptive of individuals, but... You know, I don't know. For your own entertainment, just keep, like, a list of all the shit I've missed in the comments or something. Just go, like, secrets missed. 15 so far, as I said. I'm having fun, so, just, you know, let me have fun. Please. I need it now. Well, we have another egg here. And we can kind of see people's hunger levels here. Which I don't really know how far down that goes, but we should be okay for food for the most part. Oh, and here's another rock. We can add that to our stack. That's essentially what just Can's gonna be doing this entire time. And let's go use the iron key on this door we got. Well, we can press the tab to access the map. Here's our map. I guess I didn't really show that off. So we can also write things down, like, I think we can. Yeah, here we go. This is stuff. Oh, this is tough. Okay. And I'll just remove that. Remove it. There we go. Oh. What? X marks the spot? I don't know how to remove it. Oh, just right-click it. I think someone's coming behind me. Or not. But anyways, yeah, that's the map. It's kind of neat. There's also different levels and stuff. Trust me, we'll be using it a whole lot. We'll be marking down particular things that we see. I'm just trying to see if there's anything on these walls. This is a very suspicious cavern. Okay, I guess not. Alright, so we have a door here with the turtle out there. Oh, we have some more shit over here. Well, let's see. It's a tattered shirt. Because Jack keeps getting all the clothes and everyone else gets to be naked. Okay, so this is gonna, I think, teaching us something about the game right now. So we essentially have the ability to chuck shit around. I'm just gonna do this, and you can just throw it like that. So it's teaching us that this is gonna close it. Yeah. So what we essentially want to do here is we want to chuck that over there, and just we're good. And there's a letter here. And using that letter, actually. It says, welcome to my island. I hope your journey was not detrimental to your health. You will find it to be a wonderful Yep, most perilous place on Earth. I don't have high hopes for your survival, but so you might as well equip yourself. All right, we're going to take the rock back because we can actually throw the note and that will have the same effect and we still get our throwing weapon. So let's get another shirt here. Well, that's good. And then now we start giving stuff to Pat. Hello. That really missed him. I think I used his unarmed slot there. Misses are horrible. All right, well, we got all our stuff back, and we have more turtle steaks. So killing enemies gives us steak. This is an important RPG element. I'm sure we'll serve us all in due time. And there's a giant rock thing in the middle here, but we'll discover what that does a little bit later, because I was spending forever in that character selection screen, and I gotta cut it here. So next episode, more Legend of Grimrock. So take care, everybody. Bye.